Thanks for sticking around. Again, remember, you can always donate whenever you want. Click the link. Do what you can. We all really appreciate it, and they really appreciate it, as you're probably beginning to see listening to these interviews. Our next one is a very interesting, very special one, because Dr. Ken Jeong interviews Dr. Rishi Desai. Rishi, you might recognize him. He's been around the block, as my dad used to say. So here's Ken and Rishi. Enjoy.
Hi, this is Ken Jeong, and I am talking to Dr. Rishi Desai of Osmosis, and we are here talking to benefit Project Cure, which is providing PPEs and other equipment to hospitals all over the country in need during this coronavirus pandemic, or COVID-19. And Rishi, it's an honor for me to talk to you. You are my hero for bringing truth to power, and you are reminding us all as a society, regardless of ideology, you cannot gaslight a virus. This is a global problem. This is not just a national problem. This is not just one political problem. This is a global problem where we all have to work together.
Thank you so much. The first thing I'll say is that I think when I first found out I had the opportunity to talk to you, I was thrilled. And the reason for that is that I think in my life, I always aim high and sometimes I settle low. And I aimed to be a comedian. I really genuinely wanted that. I didn't get that, and so I settled for MD instead. And so I'm talking to someone who's both, which I think is pretty awesome. So,
wait, that blows my mind. So that's true. You actually did want to be a comedian earlier on in your life?
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those things. I've always wanted to try to get the courage to go and do stand up. I've never done it, but it's one of those things where I take notes in my bedstand and kind of jot down things that I thought were funny during the day, and I'll pitch things to my 3-year-old son, and he'll laugh. I think just confused, but no, I definitely do think that what you do is amazing, and I think it's a huge honor to talk to you.
Well, I respectfully disagree, Rishi. I think you look at me. I think America can look at me, and anyone in medicine, if they look at me do my comedy, they're like, "Oh, I could be that bad. I could do that too." So thank you, thank you nonetheless. But what. In all seriousness, what you are doing is so important. And please, you know, describe what you do for Osmosis. I actually subscribe to your YouTube channel and your background and your medical background, because you got a lot of credits that aren't on IMDb like mine. So you got some legit credits. So tell me.
As a chief medical officer, what I do day to day is a lot of content. With COVID-19, all hands on deck on making good education for COVID-19 is what we're doing now.
And thank you for all you do. And your videos are amazing, and they're way over my head. Now, some can argue it doesn't take much, either literally or figuratively. I mean, like today I was watching a video about, you know, talking about angiotensin receptor blockers and how that may or may not be beneficial in patients with ARDS. And you know what? That's not what I talk about on The Masked Singer. I'm really trying to figure out the unicorn's Tory Spelling. So it's a little bit different what I do now. But what you are doing, I find you are not only informing the public how you would see on news outlets, but you are informing other physicians. My wife's a physician, and coincidentally, we were talking about like ACE inhibitors and its relation to acute respiratory distress syndrome. So, and she had to repeat it 10 times because it took me a while. So it was a great afternoon, but something that you covered in 2 minutes to other physicians. But what inspired you to do that in reaching out to physicians only as opposed to talking to the public? And what are kind of the benefits of that?
So one of the things I realized is that there are almost two different arenas where we're fighting COVID-19. One is in the community, and we talk about flattening the curve, and the main message there is pretty simple. It's stay at home. You know, stay at home as much as you can. Don't go out unless you absolutely need to, and if you need to go out, wear a mask and be careful.
So So basically be a celebrity. I get it. I stay at home. I don't like to get out. Yeah, yeah. So, but no, yeah, everyone now is living like a celebrity nationwide. So you get it. It's not so great, isn't it? So, but you know, I think at the forefront right now, and what everyone is talking about, whether it's criticism of call to action, in terms of your forecast for a vaccine, what is your projection of that?
The fact is, I don't think vaccine is going to get here in any time frame that's going to be meaningful for us right now. So it's likely going to be 2021, I think. And that means that we have to figure out what to do between April of 2020 and whenever that happens. And a lot of the strategies that we're talking about and doing now are around figuring out how to, you know, we were talking about at the front, kind of flattening the curve. But also, the other half that we haven't talked about is strategies around raising the line. How do you raise the line around healthcare capacity, right? So you have this curve, but you got to raise that bar up. And there are things we can do today.
Yeah, I don't think that's the first I've ever heard of the term raising the line and what you've described. Just, yes. And I do think right now, well, we both live in California, you know, as of right now, as we're doing this, there's talk in the media, you know, just not to be complacent. The curve appears to be flattening, but not to be complacent. You know, being able to provide this equipment is raising the line. And I believe that we all need to think that way. Just be unselfish. Think of other people. Think of, you know, when it like when we're in California, it's not about just protecting ourselves to protect ourselves. We protect ourselves so we don't infect somebody else. We don't infect a loved one. We don't affect someone, you know, in society, you know, in terms of, you know, raising the line. I believe that's what Project Cure is all about.
If you asked any healthcare provider what they want two things right now, right? They want to feel protected. And they want rest. A lot of them are fatigued. So if you think about those in turn, if one healthcare provider gets sick with COVID-19, just one, that person has lunch, they have dinner, like you, they may have a partner in medicine as well. All those people get exposed. Many of those people get quarantined. If our chain breaks at the healthcare system, we all break. And this is why it's so important to have their backs. We have to have healthcare providers' backs right now. And that's what, you know, things like getting N95 masks is all about, as I see it.
You know, when I first saw you on TV, I was like, man, he is just telling it like it is. And I just give you so much props for your fearlessness, your passion. And at its best, medicine is also an art form. And you have made this your art. And in terms of you telling me that, you know, you wanted to be a comedian growing up, you're so much better what you are. You're a true artist, you're a true visionary, and you're inspiring. And you're inspiring, you know, old farts like me, you know. So it really is just it's just an honor to talk to you. And I look forward to talking to you in the future. I look forward to, you know, having a drink with you person to person where I can pick your brain a little bit more. And I just want to thank everyone at Medscape. I want to thank everyone at Project Cure. Please donate to the number that you see below us. And most of all, I you are truly one of my heroes and a role model for me. It is I've been waiting. I'm just so excited to have talked with you, and thank you for continuing to inspire and more importantly, continuing to educate all of us. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, Ken. I can't follow that up with anything more than just donate to Project Cure. It's been such an honor, Medscape. Thank you.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, man.
You can join Osmosis to raise the line and flatten the curve by simply going to osmosis.org/COVID-19. Thanks a lot. Take care.